Welcome back to Let's Play Clannad. Gotta say, this is a little disorientating, because I was just in through Little Busters last night for many hours, and, I haven't gone through any paths yet. I have seen a few spoilers online. That's one of the bad sides to having the internet, is spoilers are bound to be heard. So now I'm still confused about the whole plot, so all in all, despite there being some spoilers that spoiled some of the plot for me, it didn't entirely, because I still don't know what the fuck is going on with them, really. I'm just like, what? But luckily, I've decided not to read further into the spoiler, so it won't spoil it too much. Anyway, my thoughts on Little Buster so far is, it's pretty awesome. I haven't got to any of the sad parts yet, but it's pretty awesome so far. It's hilarious. There's like this little baseball practice thing. It's this minigame, which is hard to believe since it's a visual novel. And it's just hilarious. They like go into chibi form like that. You've got to like hit the baseball like that with a bat. And she has a terrible throw, and half the time I'll bat the freaking ball at one of her cats, which is hilarious. Or it hits him in the balls, which is also hilarious. Or from time to time it might hit the other guys that's batting, or just, it's just freaking crazy. It's weird. And the battle thing is just also weird. But anyways, enough talk of that. When I actually like complete all the paths and all that, I will see how it stands. I will point out how it stands up with Canon and Clannad. And if I watch the Air anime by that time, I'll also compare that one as well. I won't like put any spoilers, I'll just be like, if Little Busters is better than Canon, for example, I'd be like, well, I'd say Little Busters is better than Canon. Nothing more. Anyways, on with Clannad. Tatomi stands next to me. We started walking while our shoulders touched each other. The entire school doesn't have the presence of people. Completely opposite of what it is usually. I will just say this though. Tamoya and Yuichi, better protagonist than Riki, that's for sure. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the guy, it's just, he just doesn't have that kind of charm that Tamoya and Yuichi have. I mean, they're like fun, easygoing guys, they're just like awesome, hilarious, but this Riki guy is a bit like, to be honest, a bit like me. That's probably why I don't see him as awesome. He seems like this really, I don't know how to describe his character. And also he has this ridiculously high voice when he actually talks during baseball practice and fights. It's weird. Which is kind of weird when I get around to LP and he'd be like, I am going to give this guy a manly voice. It shall be my voice. A much deeper voice. While this guy originally had a very high voice. Consider it me giving you balls. Well, drop it. I don't even know what the fuck I'm talking about. The entire school doesn't... Wait, I already read that line. Even students with club activities aren't here because of the holidays. The sunlight streams silently through the leaves onto the pathway. I had a bad premonition as we got near the school building. Okay, back to Little Busters again. I know I'm yammering away about it a little too much, as the last part obviously showed. But there's one thing I don't like about Little Busters. Minor characters like the lunch lady or something like that, and stuff like that, they don't have voice actors. Other classmates that aren't even secondary characters don't have voice actors. It's kind of lame. It's a bit of a downgrade considering that Canon had that, and Clannad had that, and Air, for all I know, probably had the same. I don't know, to be honest. What surprised me is Air came after Canon, from what I heard, yet it doesn't seem to be quite as successful as Canon. And the anime seems to be a lot shorter as well. Might check out Air as well, I suppose, but I doubt it's better than Canon. I mean, sure, you can't judge it before you even watch it, but still, I just get that kind of feeling, you know? The door to the shoe rack needs a proper key. You don't have the key to enter the school building, right? There's also a character that reminds me of Kotomi in that one. She doesn't have, like, the same hairstyle or anything like that. It's just the same kind of, like, bookworm kind of-ness to her. But her voice is very, weak sounding, in my opinion. It's like this really weak person kind of voice. It's kind of, it bugs me, to be honest. It just makes it sound like she's just gonna collapse and just like end up in hospital or something. It's just weird. I don't know how to describe it. You'll see what I mean when we get to that, you know, months away from now. Hell, probably next year, probably. Who knows? It's gonna be a long road. A visual novel. I'm fine with that, but I wonder why. I couldn't suggest going to a different place now that we were here. And then Kotomi started walking briskly. With her usual quick pace, she heads by the edge of the school building and turns the corner. You wouldn't get anything even if we go that way. We suddenly stopped under a hallway window as I immediately followed her. She jolts and loosens the window frame without any words. The window suddenly opened with a thud sound. Somehow the lock here seems to be left broken. I see. This is your hobby, right? Never mind, I'll go first then. I give back the things to Kotomi for a while and put my hands on the window frame.
中に入ったらね、すぐにお靴を脱ぐの。
Nope, that's not the reason why we're going to get scolded. That's not it either. There are countless reasons, so I'll go on ahead. There really wasn't anyone inside the school except Kotomi and me. The atmosphere is different compared to when I'm skipping and strolling around during lesson. It's like looking at a backstage that's slightly more out of this world than usual. A strange feeling. Kotomi just walks in without thinking about such things. She took out the familiar key in her possession and opened the sliding door of the library. The quiet and deserted room where you can only see books, and bookshelves, and a window, and tables, and chairs. Wait, did I read that line, Flair? No, I don't think I did. Hope you viewers read it, because I don't think I did. Is it because of the closed window that the scent of the dust and paper is stronger than usual? Fillmore, was the library this huge? She nods for no reason. Kotomi probably always saw the library like this before she met me. Kotomi advances to the usual spot and immediately takes off her shoes and socks. And as always, she jumps up in a circle as if she's going to collapse. After that, she walks to the edge of the wall and leaves. Open the east side window. I could feel the cold air disappearing as the light swayed along with the curtain. She brings out a mop from the tools locker. She diligently wipes the floor many times with her slender arm. Kotomi black-clothed and barefooted amongst a countless number of old books. Just as I thought, it was somehow fresh and nostalgic. The last thing she took out was the cushion which she placed on the floor. As Kotomi says that, the library becomes a pretty snug fit place.
Tomoya-kun, お腹、空いてない？
That's right. I woke up early today, so I'm a little bit hungry. I didn't wake up early. I woke up at 3 p.m.
ちょっと早いけど、お昼ご飯にする？
To be fair, though, I was up till about 7 in the morning playing through Little Busters. That's fine with me, but I haven't bought anything yet. I guess I should have bought something outside.But Tomoe looks straight at me, and it seems she's about to say something.
Tomoe-kun, だとちょっと少ないかもしれないけど。
She brought forward the cloth bag containing the box lunch which she had placed on the desk.
これ、二人で食べたいの。
She takes out a flat paper square box from inside it.I've been wondering about it when I was holding it. Is that some sort of pizza? Kotomi slowly shakes her head.
Apple pie なの。初めて作ってみたから、うまくできたかわからないんだけど。
She opens the paper box. A bittersweet scent suddenly escapes.It's a round pie with fox-colored burn marks here and there. It's luxuriously thick and round, and there are letters, sheep decorations attached to it. It seems there's a starch syrup on the surface, and it doesn't look different from those sold in stores. This is genuine, huh?
焼き具合はうまくできたと思うの。リンゴはちゃんと紅玉を使って、バターも無塩バターなの。仕上げにラム酒で伸ばしたアプリコットジャムを塗ったの。
She rummages inside her cloth bag as she explains it to me wholeheartedly. Two paper plates, a plastic knife, forks, and paper cups.She lines up all the necessary things on the library reading desk. No, I'm completely different when it comes to eating food. You know, people like would use a knife to cut things up. I'm just like, screw it! All I need is the fork! I also pull in a nearby chair and seat myself in front of the ready dining table.
紅茶もね、初めてちゃんとお茶っ葉を使ってみたの。お茶っ葉はレディーグレイにしてみたの。
She's finally going to get down the pie after pouring in the aroma of the expensive black tea into a cup.
今から半分こするの。
She puts the knife in the big pie and cuts it. She first half the pie, then half it again and again. It seems it's her first time earnestly.Cutting like this, making me break a smile. The big semicircular pie divided into four little pieces. She then put the slices onto the two plates.
半分こ。
She presents to me the larger portion after she said that. Yeah, thanks.
いただきましょう。
いただきましょう、whatever. Reciting that, I stab the fork into the pie.I try stuffing all of the pie into my mouth. I wonder if she baked this morning. It's still slightly warm, and the sweetness is just right. Kotomi was gazing at me as I tasted it. Is this really your first time making this?
おいしくない?
Nope, I say it's unbelievably good.The machine's malfunctioning again. It seems she's having a hard time replying when she's really tense, so I guess I have to rephrase what I just said before. Ever notice that my voice is like constantly changing? Sometimes it'll be like this, and then all of a sudden it's like this, and then it's this, and then it's this. It's just like, my voice is like I have, like, it's as if someone like just clicking some button on my voice is like, no, that one. No, that's the evil black one, sorry. The homemade apple pie is really delicious. It's so delicious that it's kind of hard to believe that it's your first time making it. I could eat a lot of it. It's that delicious. Do you understand now? She clears her mind. The wiring's finally connected.
Tomoya-kun, sore, hontou ni hontou?
It's really true.
Yokatta. Totemo ureshii no.
Her smiling face seems like it's overflowing. I stop my hand and look at that face of hers unintentionally. I just think that it's nice to see you smile. You had a hard facial expression when we first met.
Hachimete atta toki?
Her eyes shifted.
Ano toki wa kinchou shite ta shi, choppiri kowakatta kara.
She hangs her head a little as she answers. Is that so? She was nervous. I don't seem to understand what she meant by that. She drops her eyes at the pie she was eating as if embarrassed. Can I have another piece? Why do you have to talk about this right now when I have only not long ago woke up and I am rather hungry? What would you do with the other half after that?
おやつに残しておくの.
You know, I'm trying to picture the anime Tomoya, you know, with his mouth moving and everything like that, but instead of his voice, you hear my voice. I'm trying to picture how that would seem like. I think I could probably do like the kind of, you know, like what they do with the with a bridge series of animes and stuff like that. I'm gonna actually try that out just to see if I can like get my voice to like go with perfectly sync up with the anime character talking, just to see how it would look. At some point anyway, probably. She seemed like a little kid. Thanks for the food. It was almost past noon when we finished eating. Usually we must clean up the library desk for the mess, but today we're kinda held back. For now, both of us can do anything we like. Although I realize that we don't have anything we can do in this room. Incidentally, I also realize that right now we're secretly together in this room. If this was a hentai kind of thing, they'd probably have sex in this scene. Not even joking, because I've actually gone through that in one visual novel, which I found was very random. I look at Kotomi's appearance. She puts her fingers together in front of her and moves them restlessly, as if embarrassed. Know what, I'm kinda glad that Key came to their common senses and actually made it so like, there is no hentai in these ones, you know, because really, it just would seem so out of place. It's like this really amazing story, and then they ruin it with a little hentai scene. It's just like, it's not needed, don't put that scene there. What are we going to do now? I try and ask her. Kotomi also looks at the floor and thinks.
2人で.
She said it suddenly. So I thought, but she becomes silent again. Together? What?
2人で. 一緒に. 5本を読みたいの.
That's what I thought. Hey, isn't a book something you can't enjoy reading together? Well, we could also try, though. Our hobbies are different. More than that, our reading speed is completely different. Anyhow, I won't mind if we're kids looking at a picture book, but I don't think it would be that fun for us to do now. Kotomi's head is still inclined looking at me. It was her unusual thinking it over face. If Kotomi really wants that, then I have no reason to hesitate. Well, what book are we going to read?
Oh,
well, was about to say next time, but then I'm like, you know what? Screw it. We're going to continue this on for this weird as fuck scene. Her gaze went everywhere as she started to speak. You might know what I'm referring to, and you might not. If you do not, then prepare yourself for a weird scene coming up. She becomes silent again. I feel that today's Kotomi is a bit different from usual. It seems she's opening up to me bit by bit. Those things that she's been locking inside her heart. Of course, I don't feel bad about it. It's just, how do I say it? It feels like she's moving at a quick pace. But in the end, Kotomi said,
やっぱりいいの?
She gives me a modest smile, and it seems she decides to hide her treasure from me one more time. I think it might be because of me. If that's the case, I open my mouth. Would you let me hear you read books? Surprised, she tilts her head. I like to watch Kotomi reading books, and I also like your voice. Is it a no? Her facial expression changes to a really cheerful expression just from me asking that.
とても、とても素敵なの。 Tomoya-kun, どんな本がいい?
That's right, a book that's been written by a Japanese novelist. Also something that's fun to read. Also, it's your favorite book.
日本の作家が書いた本で、読むと楽しい気持ちになって、私のお気に入りの本。私、探してみるの。
She stands up and runs towards the bookshelves. Hey, Kotomi. It seems I have no choice but to wait. Exactly 20 minutes later, Kotomi returned from the forest of bookshelves holding under her chest a single book.
選んできたの。
Thanks for your hard work.
智也君が気に入るかどうかわからないけど。
We won't know unless you read it, right?
それじゃあ。 読むの?
Read the part you like if it's long.
分かったの。
She sits on the... Don't you mean she sits, not seats. Sits on the yellow cushion. She then opens the cover and flips its page.
よほど遠い過去のこと。 秋から冬にかけての短い期間を私は 変な家族の一員として過ごした。そしてその間に、私は一つの恋をしたようである。She
started talking with a little difficulty. Only a little time has passed, but it seemed it's obviously a short story. I listened carefully without worry. Several hours later, she's still reading. It didn't obviously skip that far. Honestly speaking, I'm glad that was still content. Just listening to her musical voice echoing around is enough for me. Kotomi looks like she's in a daze during that time. Her voice has become smooth, and I can feel that each line carries a sentiment. I rest my chin in my hand, looking at her eyes that are chasing down the letters with her finger that's placed on the page. Where is this place? Oh, here we go, viewers. I can hear a sound from somewhere. A sound I haven't heard before. But still, it's a nostalgic sound. Well, it would be impossible no matter what, if that's how you practice.
Violin mandan nano.
I see, that's a new genre.
Dango no hana sakeba, watashi wa ureshii.
Kotomi strokes the violin and at the same time hums a meaningless song. Dango? I had a bad premonition as I turned around, and behind me was Vergara. she was simmering something in a big pot. What the hell is that pot for?
パンも似ているんです。
Why are you boiling bread? Also, that pot somehow stinks and it really stinks.
今晩から団子たちが恋を始めるんです。
I peer inside a box that she placed on the floor. Whoa! The box is filled with squirming tango. Rogawa scoops a bread broth with a ladle and pours it to the loving dango. The big family of dango are becoming darker and darker, one by one very fast.
Oh, dango tachi ga!
Rogawa moves around in confusion as the whole family gets annihilated.The way they expanded was quite weird as well. This whole scene is weird. I wonder if something happened with the function of my brain. Next to Furugawa is Fujibayashi, who was doing a fortune telling with playing cards for some reason. What do you mean for some reason? That's normal, actually. She sluggishly but correctly lines up the cards on the floor.
わかりました。占いの結果、岡崎さんは分裂症と診断されました。
Who has schizophrenia? More than that, how did you know about that using fortune telling?
そんな見方こそが分裂心理というものなんです。
ダメよ、リョウ。そいつは私の患者よ。
I was thinking it was about time for you to show up.
っていうか、この部屋なんか臭くない
?That's due to Furugawa's boiled bread.
パンを煮る好機は、実に人間の心理を不健康にするものなのよ。
You're talking about nonsensical things and your lines have become weird too.
それも全く、パンを煮る好機のためね。
Anyway, this is a dream, right? It must be right, because no matter what, everyone wouldn't be this twisted unless it's a dream.
早くうまいものを買ってこないか?
At least listen to people even in dreams!
すみません。私、病院に行ってみなければなりません。
You two? What are you talking about? Doesn't relate to us.
団子たちが、団子たちが!
道草を食った団子は
Ah, it's that beautiful track. What a nice way to, like, exit that dream, isn't it?Have Shining in the Sky, I think this track is called. It's a real beautiful track, gotta say. But yeah, that scene was weird. I did tell you it's gonna be weird. I would put in the clip from the anime, but I don't know if this part has gone on for too long, and to be honest, I can't be asked. If you haven't seen the anime, go watch it. Blue Skull Dragon 87 recommends you go watch it. That's my advertisement for this part here.Go watch Clannad and Clannad After Story. Don't just watch them, freaking buy them, okay? They were released. They only region 1, so if you're in the US and all that, you can just buy it and be on your merry old way. If you're not, if you're like me in region 2, just buy the DVDs and use a multi-region DVD player like I do.Go on! Freaking support the official release there, you know! Buy the freaking DVDs! Same with Canon as well. Hell, even the same with Air, even though I haven't actually seen it. Just freaking buy the stuff, okay? And also, just before we, like, leave this part here, if any of you want to see, like, a bit more of Little Buster's, like, what I was talking about, like, the whole...baseball mini game thingy practice thing like that. If you want to see any of that, just tell me and I'll put it in a video. Not in one of these videos, it'd be like just a video entitled Random Little Busters or something like that. I don't know. And the fighting scenes. If you want to see that, just ask and I'll just make a video for it. Because otherwise, you won't be seeing any of that for many months. Anyways, I love that part of the track. Just let it play for a second. It's beautiful. Anyways, that was just fantastic music. Shinji Orito, you are awesome. He also did the music for Little Busters as well, I think. He's basically Key's main composer. He's a genius. He is among one of my favorite composers, I've gotta say. I mean, he's just awesome. I mean, this music is just freaking fantastic. Fair play, Shinji, you are awesome. You got my respect, man. See you next time.